Buntu Survives Poison. Buntu was an orphan. He was very helpful to people in difficulty, but always played pranks with those who tried to take advantage of his goodness. While some people thought that he was quite clever, some others took him to be a fool. Buntu worked with different households and earned just enough to maintain himself. He had only few needs and had no desire for any comfort. Near his village lived a landlord named Rajul Shah. He owned an estate some 5 miles away. About 100 families lived in his estate as his subjects and paid him tax. Rajul Shah visited his estate from time to time. It was customary for his subjects to entertain him with choice food whenever he went to the house of any one of them. "Buntu, I want somebody to accompany me to my estate. My servants are busy. Will you go with me, holding the umbrella above my head?" Rajul Shah asked Buntu. "People consider it a blessing to be in my company," he added. "I too would like to be blessed, sir, but I am hungry. Let me eat at your home and then I will set out with you," said Buntu. Rajul Shah laughed. "You will get much better food once we reach our estate. Just tell your tummy to wait for an hour or so," he said. Buntu kept quiet. He walked alongside the landlord holding an umbrella above his head. At the estate, the landlord had to remain busy deciding a dispute between 2 farmers over a piece of land. Since he did not go to anyone's house, nobody offered him any food. Hours passed. By the time the dispute was settled, it was noon. Poor Buntu was almost dying with hunger and thirst, but he had no other go than wait under a banyan tree. "I must hurry back home as I am expecting an important guest," the landlord told his people. "In that case, sir, please carry these with you, since you won't have any time to eat or drink them here," said the 2 farmers. One of them had brought roasted chicken and the other some fruit juice. Just then, a problem regarding another land was brought to his notice and one of the complainants invited him for lunch. The landlord was sure that the lunch would be sumptuous, so he decided to stay on. He had the roasted chicken packed in an earthen pot and covered with a piece of cloth. He then called Buntu and said, "My boy, take this home to my wife and tell her that I will be late. Now don't open it on the way, for there's a bird inside which will fly away the moment it gets a chance. And don't open this mug either. It contains deadly poison. The mere smell of it could kill you. Do you understand?" "Oh yes," replied Buntu and started on his return journey. The landlord ate his lunch, took a rest for a while and then began walking back home. As he had a good lunch, he now dreamed of a sumptuous dinner consisting of the chicken and the delicious fruit juice awaiting him at home. Midway, there was a lake. The landlord saw someone lying asleep under a tree enjoying the cool breeze. But the fellow looked familiar. The landlord went closer. The fellow asleep was none other than Buntu. Beside him lay the earthen pot and the mug, both empty. The landlord shook him awake and he sat up and looked absolutely surprised. "What's the matter with you?" asked the angry landlord.
"Matter with me, sir? Am I still alive?"
"What do you mean?" demanded the landlord. "Sir, a sudden gust of wind tore away the cover of the pot and as you had rightly feared, the bird flew away at once. I was heartbroken. How to show my face to you? I decided to put an end to my life. So I drank up the poison the mug contained and lay down sure to die in a moment. But now I realize what a blessing it was to be in your company. I survived the deadly poison." Buntu bowed to a speechless Rajul Shah.
Please like, share and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Do provide your feedback in the comment section below. Thanks for listening.